Gothic architecture. History. The Gothic architectural style that flourished in Europe during the High and Late Middle Age. It evolved from Romanesque architecture and was succeeded by Renaissance architecture. It originated in 12th century Northern France and England as a development of the Norman architecture. Its popularity lasted into the last 16th century, before which the style was known as Latin. The Gothic architecture is also known as pointed architecture or ogival architecture. Architecture became a leading form artistic expression during the late Middle Age. Structural element: pointed arch, rib vaults, flying buttresses, columns and spires, towers and spires, rose window and gargoyles. First, pointed arch. Pointed arch was widely used in the structure as a decorative purpose. The pointed arch were commonly used for the arches, windows, doorways, traceries and later Gothic style decorating the facade. This pointed arch was not only decorative purpose but also practical purpose also. The pointed arch are two center arches. There are three types of pointed arches. First, equilateral pointed arch. Second, obtuse pointed arch. Third, acute pointed arch. This pointed arch also known as the lancet arch. Rib vault. The Gothic rib vault was one of the essential element that made possible the great height and large window of the Gothic style. The Gothic rib vault was made of the diagonal crossing arches by ribs. These ribs are directed the thrust outward to the corner of the vault and downward via slender clonettes and buildings columns to the pillars and column below. Basically, ribs are supported the structure and distribute the load to the columns. Flying buttresses, an important feature of the Gothic architecture. The buttresses were placed in the row on either side of the building. Basically, these flying buttresses are used for decorative as well as practical purpose also. These buttresses carried the load of the roof or vault. The buttresses had existed since Roman time. The buttresses had arches rise from columns or from freestanding piers. Columns and piers. In early French, the Gothic architecture, the capital of column were molded after the Roman column of the Corinthian order. The columns in the nave alternated with the more massive piers to provide the support for the walls. The columns are ornamented with the stone rings as well as with carved leaves. The piers were rectangular and floated with a much taller in height. Towers and spires. Towers and spires are flanged were an important role feature of the Gothic building. The tower usually the last part of the structure to be built. Construction usually took many years and it's extremely expensive. In later period of the Gothic pointed arch is a needle-like structure in the spire were often added to the tower giving them much greater height. The variation of the spires was flanged, slender, spear-like spire which was usually placed on the transom where it crossed nave. Rose window. The rose window is often used as a generic part applied to the circular window. The window are divided into segment by stone mullion and tracery. Rose window also known as wheel window in the beginning. In the Gothic building, rose window used in tracery with the stained glass. Basically, stained glass window are one of the most important feature of the Gothic architecture. In the stained glass, they mostly use primary color and secondary colors. Gargoyles. In Gothic architecture, the gargoyles are also important feature. These gargoyles are used for the decorative purpose and practical purpose also. basically to convey the rainwater from the roof and away from the side of the building. The gargoyles appear in the Europe in the 12th century. Many early gargoyles are depict the version of the animals and birds, such as dragon in the France. Thank you.